YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me today. Today is October 30th, 2022. Yeah, a little dark and steamy there at Yellowstone. They're not reporting any earthquakes there at Yellowstone, but they have had recently a magnitude 2.94. Yeah, I guess they're sleeping on the job once again. Look how dark that steam is. It was probably in the Madison River area, the earthquake. Here we have Maple Creek, and it came in as a magnitude 2.94. Yeah, my grandkids are here, so you'll hear the noise in the background. And let's reduce this and then bring it up so you can see. Okay, over here on the west, on the right is Western Boundary. This is Maple Creek, Little West Thumb, and Soda Butte. We have USGS map. It shows Wyoming, Montana, all the way down here to the Great Salt Lakes. One day, all magnitudes. So let's go to 7 days and see what we got here. 57 earthquakes. This one would be Stanley, Idaho. And we'll zoom in. 24. The last one they reported was on the 28th. Yeah, so let's see, what would be the largest they reported? We got a 1.7, the Madison River area. Look at all those quakes up there. All right, let's zoom in. Okay, 18 in the last week, but you know, and I know, they've been a lot more than that. Here we got Purple Mountain. Let's bring this out a little bit. Yeah, Madison River, see that? Again, the last one they reported was on the 28th. And they do downgrade them greatly. All right, let's go back to the monitor. Here we have the live stream view, and you see we got another small one right here, but I have not downloaded that data. It takes forever to save the data, go through each one. But anyways, this one right here is the one that I'm showing. And it's across the park. Top one is West Thumb, Soda Butte, Maple Creek, and the bottom one would be Western Boundary. Soda Butte there on the northeast area of the park. I don't see any screaming today, but there's been a lot of popping of the rock, and they actually got them all. Oops. Got them marked in red. See if I can find that one. Okay, there's one there. And another one there. Finding them is often hard to. If you have a larger monitor, you can see the ones that are marked in red. I'm trying to find this one. All right, let me make that bigger. Let's see. It looks like it's right there. Yeah, right there. Okay, let's close this out. Yeah, we got one in red there and there. And let's see, it might be there. Another one right there. Another one. Oops, I don't know where that one's at. Let's see, it looks like maybe. Nope, right there, yeah. Okay. And then I don't see anything recent. Unless that's it there. Oh, right there. That's the most recent one. Marked in red. Yep, the ground is popping. And that's the direction that the magma chamber, the hot spot, slowly moving towards the northeast area of the park. All right, so this is the most recent there for the Madison River area, the 2.94. And it's marked in red, but they're probably not home. We got another one right here, another small one. That one comes in, let me bring it down, as a magnitude 1.63. That's a small one. Okay, the next one marked in red will be this one right here, 8:36 Universal Time. That comes in as a magnitude 1.82. Let's see. Okay, I'm not going to bother with that one. Yeah, you know, a lot of magma came in hot. I don't see the hot gases. Indication of hot gases, but yeah, probably dike intrusion. I talked about that before, how we probably have cracks in the ground where the magma's coming up. Okay, another one right there. This one could be a little larger, but I got a magnitude 1.64. And then, let's see, this one's larger. Let's bring that one up. Okay. That would have been at 2:35 a.m. Central Daylight Time. There in Yellowstone, probably 1:35 a.m. There's its signature. And let's bring it down. We'll see what the... Okay, it's a 2.55. See, these are getting close to threes. And, yeah, being the weekend, no one's home. And we'll go back to the spectrogram right there. Okay, and there was a smaller one right before that. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.87. It is smaller. I'll bring it down so you can see it right there. Okay, what else do we got? Oh, I don't think I did that one there. We'll just jump around here. Okay, go back up to this one here. Another one at 1933 Universal. Another one right there at 1657 Universal. I guess the one I just, 1321 Universal. So it looks like the biggest ones that have happened within the last 24 hours would be this one right here. Yeah, 6:40 a.m. their time. Or 7:40 Central Daylight Time. Almost a magnitude 3. Yeah. Yep, a little dirty. You can see down here by Firehole River that it's dirty. Yep, I wanted to check and see what was going on again. Not all rock melts at the same temperature. What's happening is the water is heating up. And, yeah, because of the magma chamber underneath. But rock melts between 1,100 degrees Fahrenheit to about 2,400 degrees Fahrenheit. And so as that, hot, acidy water heats up, it melts the rock. And then you can see the results of that. I wish they would zoom in. We'll check back here in a few minutes where you can see, how dark that is. Here on the EastIdahoNews.com, they're talking about the roads that are going to be closed. Tomorrow, October 31st, Halloween will be the last day for many of the roads that are going to be closed. November 1st, the roads that are going to be closed is Mammoth Hot Springs to Norris, Norris to Canyon Village to Lake Village, the east entrance to Lake Village, Lake Village to West Thumb, South Entrance to West Thumb to Old Faithful to Madison River, and the entrance to Madison River, and Madison to Norris. Now there is going to be, the Gardner Road, which was closed because of, all that flooding that happened in June. Now that's going to be opened on November 1st. And then also, the hotel there is going to be opened on November 1st. But, which is good for tourism, I guess, for that area. But with the other roads closed, we're probably going to see less and less people on the live stream here at Yellowstone National Park. Here we have the most recent view of the static cam. For Old Faithful, looking a little dirty there. Now this was at 9:58 a.m. About a minute ago. They're an hour ahead of me. I'm Central Daylight Time and they're on Mountain Time. There's a few people there in that image. All right, they moved the camera a little bit. It's currently only 19 degrees there. Yeah, so if you're going to visit the park, yeah, definitely going to want to bundle up. It has snowed there recently. There's snow on the mountains. But that's about it for what's going on right now. Yeah, not reporting the earthquakes. It's the weekend. Who knows? They are moving it again. Yeah. So, as you know, I'll just keep an eye on everything. So, what are your thoughts about the increase in size of earthquakes? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.